So this is the last topic in Math 037, which is statistics. So what do you know about statistics? Statistics is, of course, dealing with the data. We are going to get the data, we have to rearrange the data, organize the data, and then we have to analyze the data so that we can make a conclusion from the data that we have. Okay, so but in this in your syllabus, it's very easy. You just have to know about three important elements under statistics, which is the first one will be mean, right? Mean, okay, bukan kurang aja, mean tu. It's mean, bukan, alright? Ini mean ialah purata. Ataupun kata lain ialah average, okay, average. Yang kedua ialah median, iaitu data di tengah-tengah. Okay, median ialah data di tengah-tengah, in the middle. Median. Sorry. Alright, ada median. So middle, di tengah-tengah, data di tengah-tengah. Okay, dan yang ketiga we have that mode. Mode ialah data yang mempunyai frekuensi paling banyak, kekerapan paling banyak. Okay, tak apa, you tak nampak lagi apa I'm explaining now, but I'm gonna show you what are these three things. Okay, let's say we go to first example. Katakanlah kita ada data, okay, number one, 8, 4, 6. Tak kisahlah apa-apa data lah ni kan. Contoh ada 3 data. So what you have to do firstly is to rearrange the data. So you akan susun daripada nombor kecil ke nombor besar. 4, 6, 8. Okay, so to get the mean, okay, alright, number one, to get the mean, the formula is given by you tambah semua, okay, 4 tambah 6 tambah 8. You bahagi dengan total number of data in this. So you have 4, 6, 8. So ada 3 data. So bahagi dengan 3. So bila you bahagi dengan 3, tambahlah kan. So 4 tambah 6 tambah 8, bahagi dengan 3, you dapat, kira dulu 18 bahagi dengan 3, so you dapat 6. That is the mean. Mean ialah purata. Okay, median ialah data di tengah-tengah. So to get that, you have to find the position of median. So this is number A, this is B. So to get the median, you have to find the position of median. Dekat mana? Kalau dekat sini memang tahu dah, position of median lah 6 kan. Position median lah dekat tengah-tengah nombor 2, but the median will be 6. Okay, but to eh, kalau data banyak jenuh you nak cari data di tengah-tengah. So position of median is given by, okay, formula mesti N tambah 1 bahagi dengan 2. Okay, N tambah 1 bahagi dengan 2. So N dekat sini ialah, N ialah number of data. So kita ada 1, 2, 3, number of observations. So ada 3. So in this case 3 tambah 1 bahagi dengan 2. So 4 bahagi 2 ialah 2, meaning that it is at the second position. This is the position we are looking for. Position now, dia adalah second position. So you pergi dekat data, second position ialah di position pertama, ini position kedua. So this is the second position. So which be is 6. So what is that 6? 6 is the median. So your median will be 6. Okay, in this case mode, frekuensi paling banyak tak ada. Okay, there is no mode in this case. Okay, that's how you find mean and median. Okay, tak apa, kita pergi contoh yang kedua. Let's say we have another set of data. Katakanlah saya ada 9, 2, 3, 4, 2, 6. Okay, find the mean. Mean ialah purata. Alright, so firstly rearrange the data. That you have to do ialah susun daripada kecil ke besar. 2. Okay, dah, kalau dah susun, potonglah. Lepas tu 2, alright. And next 3, 4, 6, 9. Alright, so we have this set of data. So what you have to do next is to find mean and mode and median. Alright, so firstly I'll find the mean. Mean, purata, senang sahaja, tambah semua. 2, tambah 2, tambah 3, tambah 4, tambah 6, tambah 9. How many data is in here? So N sama dengan 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So ada 6 data. So bahagi semua ini dengan 6. To get this, you have to calculate the numerator first. So 2 tambah 2 tambah dengan 3, tambah dengan 4, tambah 6 dan tambah 9, you dapat 26. So 26, you have to divide with 6, so you dapat, okay, 4.33333333, never ending. So 4.33 is enough lah. So mean is your 4.33. Okay, that is your mean, purata, average. The second one, to find the median, always you have to find the position of median. Position of median is given by the formula N plus 1 bahagi dengan 2. Tak diberi dalam exam formula, you have to know. N plus 1 divided by 2, okay, you have 6. So 6 plus 1, N is 6. So N, 6 plus 1 divided by 2, you get 7. 7 divided by 2, you get 3.5. Okay, 7 divided by 2, you get 3.5. So what is that? What does that mean? 3.5 ni ialah nombor yang berada di antara apa? Antara 3 dan 4. So your median should be at the position of third position and also the fourth position. Okay, nah, you kena tulis benda ini. Ada markah ni, alright? So third position and fourth position. So now to get the median, right? You pergi dekat data yang you dah susun tadi. Penat-penat you susun, you pergi tengok dia data yang mula-mula. Okay, third position, alright. So third position is this one, alright. Sebab ni 1, 2, 3. And the fourth position, ialah fourth position is this one. So 3 tambah 4, in this case 3 tambah 4, you kena bahagi dengan 2 pula. You kena ambil average. Sebab berbeza dengan yang tadi, tadi kita terus dapat this one. Ada satu sahaja nilai dia. Okay, because it is second position. But now kita dapat third and fourth position. Kenapa? Sebab the 3.5. So dia kena third position and fourth position. So you kena pergi dekat third position, which is this one, and fourth position, which is this one. Tambah dia 3 tambah 4, dia bahagi dengan 2. So 3 tambah 4 ialah 7. 7 bahagi 2, 3.5. So 3.5 will be your median. Okay, it is a bit different from the first example. Alright, so this is your median. And now we'll go to question C to find mode. Alright, so mode is mode ialah data yang mempunyai paling banyak. Mana yang maksud paling banyak tu ada mana yang banyak kali dia keluar. Okay, maksudnya dua lah. Dua, ada dua kali dia keluar kan. Yang lain sekali. Okay, tiga ada sekali sahaja. Empat ada sekali sahaja. Enam ada sekali sahaja. Sembilan ada sekali sahaja. So in this case, this is your mode. So mode will be dua. But if the question asks you frequency, alright, kekerapan mode, berapa banyak kali dia keluar kan, ada dua kali. So frequency of mode will be 2 also. Sebab apa? Sebab dia ada dua kali. Nangsom, dua kali. Okay, so that's the one you deal with, this kind of data. Dia ada, this one kita panggil the odd data, which is nombor ganjil. This one bilangan even data, even observations of data. Okay, so let's say example number 3. Let's say we have this set of data. Okay, let's say this is the heights of students in a class, in which is in centimeter. Alright, katakanlah ada berapa orang ni. Okay, kita kena kira dulu kan. But now what you have to do when you get the data, the first thing that you have to do is to rearrange, susun semula data daripada nombor kecil ke nombor genap. In this case, cari nombor paling kecil ialah 159. So 159. Alright, next one will be 160 lagi 160. Okay, you have 160, another one, alright, 160. Ada lagi, okay, next one 161. Ingat, dah tulis potong, eh, takut terlebih atau terkurang, okay. So now 161, okay, next one will be 165, next one 167. So next one will be, tak ada kan, okay, 17 pula, okay, 172, alright, 172, 173, and the last one will be 175. So kita dah tulis semua. How many data is there, alright? Neng, som, sam, si, ha, hop, chat, pet, kau, sik. Ada 10 data, right? Oh, maaflah mengira dalam bahasa Thailand sekali-sekali. Right, so there are n which is given by 10, right? Kau tak percaya? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Ada 10 data dekat sini, 10 observations. Alright, so now we are going to find mean, mode and median. So first question will be mean, right? So the mean is given by 159 plus 160 plus 160 plus another 160. Next one 161. Jangan malas, you kena salin semua. Tengok saya rajin ni kan. Ha, you kena contohi saya lah. Ha, 167, 172, 173 dan 175. You nak bahagi dengan n. Total number of data will be 10. Alright, so bahagi dengan 10. Kira dahulu yang belah atas. Okay, so hati-hatilah. 159, 160, 160, 160, 161, 165, 167, tambah lagi 172, 173 dan 175. Okay, so you will get 1652 divided by 10, which is given by 165.2. Because this is the height, which is 165.2 cm. Maksudnya purata. Kalau katakanlah dalam kelas ni ada 10 orang, katakanlah cikgu datang, okay, lebih kurangnya berapa tinggi you all lah. So you can say that lebih kurangnya cikgu, ketinggian kami ialah ini. Okay, kalau cikgu kata paling ramai tinggi berapa, that one will be mode. Okay, paling ramai tinggi mode. Right, so saya pergi mode dulu. Okay, paling ramai, tengok paling ramai ialah mode 1, 2, 3. Right, so that one paling ramai, and in that case B mode ialah paling ramai tinggi berapa, that one mode will be 160. Kalau soalan tanya, cikgu tanya lagi, paling ramai tinggi berapa, 160. Berapa tinggi, berapa orang yang 160 tu, that one will be frequency, asal tukar warna ni. Alright, frequency of the mode. Frequency of the mode will be given by, ada berapa kali dia keluar, 1, 2, 3. Right, so it will be 3. Jangan tertukar between mode and frequency of the mode. Okay, so next one will be, we want to find the median. Okay, sebenarnya you boleh agak-agak, median ialah yang data di tengah-tengah. Okay, macam mana nak mengira? Okay, tapi saya tak nak ajar awak macam tu lah. Okay, you boleh ni lah, you boleh buat 1, 1, 2, 2, 3, 3, 4, 4. So, tak boleh. Kalau 5, 5 tak ada data tengah-tengah ni kan? Okay, sebenarnya data dia adalah 2 ini. You kena tambah bahagi 2. Okay, but now I'm not going to show you to find that way. Alright, you have to find mathematically using the formula. Position, okay, position of median, right? It's given by n plus 1 divided by 2. Always, this is the formula. N ialah number of observations, which is 10. So, 10 plus 1 divided by 2, you get 5.5. Kalau dapat 0.5, this means that it is at the 5th position, alright? Between the 5th position and the 6th position. Itu maksudnya. That's the meaning, alright? So, you go to this set of data. So, this is the 1st position, 2nd position, 3rd position, 4th position, and this is the 5th position. So, this one. And also, this is the 6th position. So it will be this one. So 161 plus 165. So that one will be your median. So median ialah data di tengah-tengah itu, 161 plus 165. Sebab apa? Sebab this two you have to add two, okay? And then you divide by two. You find the average lah sebenarnya, okay? So in this case, 161 plus 165 bahagi dengan 2, you get 163. So this is your median. Kalau cikgu tanya tengah lebih kurangnya tengah-tengah tu berapa tinggi you all yang tengah-tengah? So 163 lah. Macam tu nak cakap. Okay, right, so that's the meaning of median. Okay, and we have the last set of data. Let's say number 4. We have example number 4. Okay, katakanlah kita data 94, 49, 55, 82, 75, and then 88, 67, 71 dan 82. Okay, let's say we have this. This is the scores of a test of a student, okay, in the class. Not your, not my class, not your class, but another class. We are talking about another class. They bad ni, kategori ni, okay. So what you have to do first is to rearrange the data. You go to the first one, 49. The next one will be I think in this case 55. So susun balik 55, and then you have 67, I think. Yeah, 67, and then 71 75, and then you have 82. Ada lagi 82, okay. Susun 88 and also 94. Okay, so ada berapa data? Okay, neng, som, sam, si, ha, hok, cat, pet, kau. Maksudnya ada 9. Kalau tak percaya, kira lah 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So ada 9 data in this case. So you can find the mean as usual. To find the mean, you have to add them all. Tambah semua. So 49 tambah 55 tambah 67 tambah 71 tambah 75 tambah 82 tambah 82 tambah 88 tambah lagi 94. You bahagi dengan berapa? Ada 9 data. You bahagi dengan 9. So you will get, okay, gonna calculate. 49 plus 55, 67, 71, 75, 82, 82, 88, and 94. So you will get 663. You divide by 9, okay. Tulis yang ni ada markah ya. So you'll get 73.67. So kalau cikgu tanya, berapa markah maths you all sebenarnya? So you tak boleh nak cakap 94, tak boleh nak cakap 49. So you boleh cakap lebih kurang macam ni lah cikgu, 73.67. Itu purata kami. Right, second one, B will be the mode. Tak kisahlah mode ke median kan. Mode, right, to find the mode is the one that has the highest frequency is of course 82 and 82 sebab dia muncul dua kali. Right, so in this case ialah 82. Okay, and the last one, to find the median, right? Data di tengah-tengah, you boleh agak sebenarnya. Macam mana kalau nak agak-agak? Okay, data tengah-tengah tengok saya buat eh. So, you pergi dari sini. 1, 1, 2, 2. Pastikan data dah susun. 3, 3, 4, 4, 5. This is the tengah-tengah. Okay? But now, saya tak nak ubah macam ini. I want you to use the formula n plus 1 divided by 2. So, in this case, kita ada n ialah 9 tambah 1 bahagi 2. 10 bahagi 2 ialah 5, which is the 5th position. That's the meaning of the position. Sorry, this is not median. Sorry, this is position. Salah dah tu. Ingat, position of median. Alright, so the 5th position. So, pergilah. 1, 2, 3, 4 dan 5. So, this will be your median. 75 is your median. You tak perlu nak tambah-tambah bahagi 2 dah sebab dia betul-betul dekat, terkena dekat situ. So, 75. Okay? Kalau yang ini, you kena bahagi 2. Kenapa? Sebab dia dapat dekat sini. Dua-dua ni. So, tak tahu nak 161 ke 165. So, last kali, you have to take the average. Apa tengah-tengah dia? So, that's why you have to divide with 2 dekat sini. Okay? But now, in this case, you don't have to. Sebab apa? You betul-betul dapat sharp at this point. So, this is your median. Alright? So, that's how you find the mode, mean, and mean, mode, and median for the ungrouped data. Alright? So, this is actually ungrouped data. Data yang betul-betul, okay? Ungrouped data. We are talking about ungrouped data, right? Ungrouped data ni maksudnya data dia betul-betul lah. Dia tak tersusun. Kalau kita susun balik pun dia tak dikelaskan, okay? Tak apa. Later, in the next video, I'm going to show you what is grouped data. So, this one you should score, okay? Full marks. Thank you.